Hi, I'm Jonathan Wild, and we are going to cover how to compute cash flows from operating activities using the indirect method. So first, what are operating activities? They are activities that affect revenues and expenses, and in turn, net income. Operating activities include things like receiving cash from customers, paying employee wages, and paying suppliers for merchandise. Now, to compute cash flows from operating activities using the indirect method, we start with net income. If you remember though, net income is based on accrual accounting, which means that timing of revenues and expenses don't usually line up with when we actually receive or pay cash. Therefore, when we use the indirect method, we take net income and have to adjust it to match the actual inflow and outflow of cash. The first set of adjustments is for income statement items that don't affect cash. These include things like bad debts expense, depreciation, amortization, depletion, and gains or losses from the sale of assets and retirement of debt. For this section, we have two general rules. First, that we subtract revenues and gains from net income when they don't include cash inflows. And two, that we add expenses and losses back into net income when they don't include cash outflows. Now, the second set of adjustments is for changes in current assets and current liabilities. And to help us out, we can follow a few guidelines. When a current asset account balance increases, subtract the increase from net income. When a current asset account balance decreases, add the decrease back into net income. And when a current liability account balance increases, add the increase back in to net income. When a current liability account balance decreases, subtract the decrease from net income. Okay, so I think this will make more sense with an example. Assume a company prepared the income statement shown here. And to start preparing the operating activity section of the statement of cash flows, we begin by listing net income. Next, we have to adjust net income for income statement items that don't affect cash. The first one we see is depreciation. Remember, depreciation expense does not include a payment of cash. It is simply allocating the cost of a plant asset over several years. Therefore, we add this expense back in to net income. Next, we see that we have a loss from the sale of equipment. This loss does not represent a cash outflow in the operating activity section. The cash flow from the sale of the equipment is actually reported in the investing activity section, which we cover in another video. Therefore, we add the loss back in to net income. Next, we see a gain on the retirement of bonds payable. This gain does not represent a cash inflow in the operating activity section. The cash flow from the retirement of bonds payable is reported in the financing activity section, which is covered in another video. Therefore, we subtract the gain from net income. Now, the second set of adjustments are for changes in current assets and current liabilities. To do this, we look at comparative balance sheets showing the current and prior year. So looking at our current assets, not including cash, we see that accounts receivable increased. This means that we collected less cash than what was reported in sales. Therefore, we subtract this increase in receivables from net income. Merchandise inventory also increased, meaning that more cash is tied up in inventory at year end. So we subtract the increase from net income. Prepaid insurance also increased, meaning cash paid for insurance is more than what we recorded in operating expenses. So we subtract the increase from net income when determining cash flows. Next, we look at current liabilities. We see that accounts payable decreased, meaning cash paid is more than purchases recorded. So we subtract the decrease from net income. Interest payable also decreased, meaning cash paid for interest, is more than the interest expense we reported on the income statement. So we subtract the decrease from net income. We also see an increase in income taxes payable, meaning cash paid for income taxes is less than the tax expense reported on the income statement. So we add the increase back in to net income. So to wrap it up, we take net income and add or subtract each of the adjustments. This gives us net cash provided by operating activities.